Hello guys, welcome to technojob.in. Here we are with the part 2 of mixture and allegations. So before going in detail about this mixture and allegations, I would like to tell about our platform, that is technojob.in. We provide jobs for BE, B.Tech students and also give information about government jobs, private jobs, walk-in drives, off-campus drives, internships and also tech news. So coming to the mixture and allegations of part 2, here we are going to solve it. Some more problems of mixture and allegations. See, in 30 liters of mixture of acid, the ratio of acid and water is 2:3. What amount of water should be added to the mixture so that the ratio of acid and water becomes 2:5? So initially it is 2:3 and later it became 2:5 by adding acid to it. So how much quantity we are adding to that, so we want to know it. So here you can solve this type of problems. You can solve in one type of method. I'll tell you how. Acid to the water is first of all 2:3, right? So 2:3. So let us in liters how it will be. See, in 30 liters, right? 30 liters of mixture of acid. So 30 into 2 liters of acid and by 5. Okay. So how much it becomes? 6. So 12. 12:18. Halves into 6, we have to add into 6, so 12:18 in liters. Okay, have this 18 becomes, see, out of 30 liters, when 12 liters is acid, then the remaining 18 liters will be a water, right? So this is how you'll solve in liters. Okay, so this just keep it aside. So then what they have said you, that in that how much acid you are adding. So acid quantity by, we are adding some of the water, how much? 18 plus some acid, how much we are adding, let it be x. Okay, so then what initially it is 2, right? 2 is the initial one, and by 5, total quantity is 5. So cross multiply, then how much you get? X equal to 12. So 12 liters you are adding the mixture to it. See, this is a somewhat a big process. You have to convert into liters and again you have to take x and everything. I'll tell you other method which doesn't add any x values or anything. See, just consider acid to water, how much? 2:3 initially, later how it became 2:5. So how, what they have said, they added some of the, see, water, they added some of the water, right? So what they added, that is okay, but the other one should be a constant value, should be a same values. See, here they given constant 2, they given, so there is no need to change the process or anything. So it is clear. So it is just keep it as a constant. Now we are adding some of the water, right? So 3 and 5, how much difference? 2 is the difference. So when 5 becomes 30, then how much 2 becomes? This is 5 means in the last one, 2:5 it becomes, no? So 5 becomes 30, then how much 2 quantity will be become? So just crisscross multiply 2 into 30 by 5, that is 12 liters. So directly you can solve it. See, whichever they'll add it, the other one should be a constant. See, here we are adding water, so we are taking a water quantity and we are doing it. If they asked you to do acid, then make acid the difference, make water as a constant. I'll tell you how if the same quantity is not given. So second problem, there are 3 containers of equal capacity, the ratio of sulfuric acid to water in the first container is 3:2, then in the second container is 7:3, and the third container is 11:4. If all the liquids are mixed, then the ratio of sulfuric acid to water, how much? So sulfuric acid to water, how much they are asking? They given you 3 containers. See, first container is 3:2, second container is 7:3, and third container is 11:4. Okay, just what you do is just add this So 5, 10 and 15. So just take an LCM for 5, 10, 15. So it is 30, right? So after doing it 30, so how much we have to multiply for 5 to get 30? It is 6, right? So multiply it 6, 10 with 3 and 15 with 2. So at what how much you are multiplying here, just multiply on the both sides of this. So then how much you will get for the first one? 18 is to 12 and 21 is to 9 and 22 is to 8, right? When you multiply with 6 on for this 3 is to 2, 7 is to 3 for 3 and 11 is to 4 for 2. So just add all the 1. 61 is to 29. If it get cancelled, just cancel it. Now we are not getting cancelled, but if it get cancelled, you can cancel it. So the what is the answer? Sulfuric acid to water is 61 is to 29. This is how you'll solve it. Like this, if they give so many and like ratios, so you can just take an LCM and you can do it. So this will come by practicing itself. It, because this is all the profit and loss, ratio and proportion, it is all mixed with. So you have to be thorough with this. See, we have another problem. 200 liters of a mixture contains milk and water in the ratio 17 is to 3. After addition of some more milk to it, the ratio of milk to water becomes 7 is to 1. Find the quantity of milk added. So how much? See, here milk is to water is 17 is to 3. And after that, how much it became 7 is to 1? See, so some of the milk is added, okay? So here in the first problem, they are same. 2 and 2, right? Acid to water. But here it is different. So 17 and 7. So they are different. So what you have to do is, what they said, they are adding milk. So we should make constant of water. So here 3 is there, here 1 is there. So I'll make it as a 3. So how to make it a 3, what you have to do, just multiply with 3. So how much it becomes? 21 is to 3. Okay, here how much? See, 17 is to 3 and 21 is to 3. So these are constant, so no need of it. Then what you have to do is, the first mixture 20 is 200 liters. Then how much the 4 is? Just cross multiply. How much you get? 40 liters of milk is added. Then the ratio became 7 is to 1. This is how you will solve it. When it is not, when the same you are not getting, just make it a constant. Which one they are adding, you just keep it aside. Which one they are not adding, just make them as a constant. So here is the other problem. A and B are two alloys of gold and copper in the ratio 7 is to 3, 7 is to 2 and 7 is to 11. If equal quantities are melted to form a alloy C, third alloy C, find the ratio of gold and copper. See, gold doesn't melt, and we will add something to the gold. So how much quantity they are asking? Just do it in the same way and give me the answer in the comment section, guys. I'll solve this in the next video. So the yesterday I have given you a question, that is, a merchant has 88 kg of sugar. A part of he sells at a gain of 10% and the remaining loss at 12%. On the total he loses 3%. What is the quantity sold at a 12%? So here, see, profit and loss 10% and minus 12%. But at last, what they given at the loss of loss of 3%, right? So minus 3%. So minus 3 of minus of minus 12 and 10 minus of minus 3. So 9 is to 13. So how much? 9 is to 13, right? So what they have said you, that a quantity loss at 12%. At 12%, how much? So like on the loss side, how much, what is the quantity he lost? So 13, right? 13 by overall how much? 22. That is 13 plus 9 is 22. That is a total quantity, profit and loss, into how much it is 88 kgs. 21 and 22 fours are 88. So 52 kgs. He losses 52 kgs on behalf of it. So this is how you will solve the mixture and allegations. And if you have missed the video of mixture and allegations, the link is given in the description, so you can go directly to the link and you can watch the video if you have missed. So thank you guys for watching this video. If you like this video, please do like, share and subscribe. Thank you.